Now, Shivai students, today we'll be starting with a new chapter of chemistry, that is physical and chemical changes. You must be aware of hundred of changes that is taking place around us every day. Like, for example, you must have seen that is seedlings grows into plants. From a seed, a plant grows. The leaves change color and fall off from the trees. Leaves are usually green, and after that they change their color, they become yellowish and they fall from the trees. Rice softens on cooking. When you cook rice, this gets soft on cooking. See your height and see the height when you were in class 1 or 2. There's a change. So you what has happened in you, that growth has taken place. So growth is a change that has taken place in you. Your height have increased. Okay, so these are some of the changes that you see every day in your life. In class 6, we have read about changes around us, where we have read that some changes are slow changes, some changes are fast changes. Slow changes are weathering of rock. From the weathering of rock, soil is made. It is a very slow change. Okay. Formation of coal and petroleum. Coal and petroleum took millions and millions of years to form. So that is a very, very slow change. Some changes are fast, like melting of ice. If you keep some ice, you will see that it melts. Burning of firecrackers. Immediately as you touch the firecracker starts burning. So that is a very fast change. Okay, so some changes are slow changes, some changes are fast changes. Some changes are desirable changes. Desirable change means which are good for you. Like for example, cooking of food. When you are taking some raw potatoes and you are cooking, you get a tasty food. So that is a desirable change. Or suppose you are want to make some paneer from milk. So that is a desirable change. Okay. Some changes are undesirable. That is not good for you. That is harmful. Like for example, spoilage of food. If the food spoils, then that is a undesirable change. Okay. So hundreds and hundreds of changes are occurring around you. Some changes are slow, some changes are fast, some changes are desirable, some changes are undesirable. So see here, every day you come across many changes in your surroundings. These changes may involve one or more substances. For example, your mother asks you to dissolve sugar in water to make a cold drink. What you do? You dissolve the sugar in water. Sugar is a solid initially and it dissolves in water to make the cold drink. So what happens? There is a complete change. Similarly, making a sugar solution is a change. Similarly, setting curd from milk is also a change. If you keep some milk, okay, and if you add a little bit of curd to it, after 10 hours, you will see that it will turn to curd. So what happens actually? In the milk, there is a bacteria. The name of the bacteria is Lactobacillus. Lactobacillus. The name of the bacteria is Lactobacillus bacteria. And in the milk, there is a carbohydrate present which is known as lactose. This lactose is present in milk. The Lactobacillus bacteria converts the lactose to lactic acid. And thus, the milk changes to curd. So this is also a change. Okay, stretching of rubber band also represents a change. You take some rubber band and you stretch it. What happens? The size and the shape of the rubber band changes. So that is a change. Make a list of changes you have noticed around you. So in your copy, make a list of 10 changes that you have noticed around you. So whenever you will watching the video, after watching the video, you make a list of 10 changes that you have noticed. Okay, so in this chapter we will be learning about two types of changes. One is physical changes, another is chemical changes. Earlier we have read about reversible changes, irreversible changes, desirable changes, undesirable changes, etc. In this chapter we will be reading about physical and chemical changes. Now, before that, what do you mean by the physical property of the substance? Physical property means any property that can be observed or measured. For example, color, mass, length, volume, density, state, etc. That is a physical property. So, if I tell you, what is your physical property? If tell me one physical property about yourself. Suppose you tell that my height is 5 feet. So, that is a physical property. I can observe that or I can measure that. Or if you say the color of my eye is black. So, that is a physical property of you. Physical property do not change the identity of the substance. Clear? So, physical property means what? The color, mass, length, volume, state of the substance is called the physical property, which you can observe or which you can measure. That is a physical property of a substance. Now we will be seeing two activities. Now activity 6.1 is cut a piece of paper into 4 square pieces. Cut each square pieces further into 4 square pieces. Lay these pieces on the floor or a table so that the pieces acquire the shape of the original piece of paper. Obviously, you cannot join the pieces back to make the original piece, but there is a change in the property of the paper. So, see here, this is a piece of paper. First, we have cut it into 4 pieces, and then this each 4 pieces we have cut it into further 4 pieces, and then we have placed it on a table. We cannot join the paper, right? Can we join? We cannot join the paper. But which physical property has changed? The size of the paper have changed. Original size was this and the size have become small now. So the size of the paper have changed. So a physical property got changed while you are cutting the paper. Though you cannot join back the paper, but the paper which you have cut, suppose this piece, it is a piece of paper only, it has not changed. So no new substance is formed here. Is there any new substance formed? No, it is a paper itself. Similarly, suppose you are breaking a chalk into pieces. When we are breaking a chalk into pieces, the small pieces of chalk which is formed, that is a piece of chalk itself. The size of the chalk has changed, but the characteristics of the chalk have not changed. It is a chalk itself. See this activity 6.2. Collect the chalk dust lying on the floor near the blackboard of your classroom, or crush a small piece of chalk into dust. Add a little bit of water to the dust and make a paste. Roll it into the shape of a piece of chalk. Let it dry. Do you recover chalk from the dust? Yes, you can get the chalk from the dust, though it might break easily. Okay, so what is chalk dust? Chalk dust is a part of the chalk itself. So, when you are breaking a chalk into powder or you are making powder of it, then what is happening? The physical property is changing, the size is changing, the shape is changing. But whatever the new substance which is formed is the chalk itself. Okay, so thus in this video we have learnt about what are changes. We have learnt about what do you mean by physical property, that is a property which you can measure or observe. And we have seen two activity where the physical property changed, that is the size changed. Okay, in the next video we'll be learning more about physical properties change or physical changes through different activities. Thank you. Namaskar.